Welcome to the module on flexible pavements. Today we will be discussing about the precautions one has to take during the laying operations of wet mix macadam in flexible pavements. Laying of wet mix macadam, if you see, the material shall be laid in one or more layers as necessary to lines, grades and cross sections shown on the approved drawings or as directed by the engineers. The thickness of a single compacted wet mix macadam layer shall not be less than 75 millimeters. When vibrating or other approved types of compacting equipments are used, the compacted depth of a single layer may be increased to 200 millimeters upon approval from the engineer. While constructing a wet mix macadam, arrangement shall be made for a lateral confinement of the wet mix on the shoulder sides. So immediately after mixing, the aggregates shall be spread uniformly and evenly. The mix may be spread either by a paver finisher or a mortar grader. The aggregates as spread should be of uniform gradation with no pockets of fine materials in between. So this is a typical diagram of a typical photograph of laying operations of wet mix macadam, where you can see a wet mix paver and different layers like a GSB first layer on the extreme right. Then you have the WM first layer and which is being spread on both the carriageways, and then you can see that on the extreme right you have a WM second layer work in progress. So once they complete the WM second layer at that area, then they will switch to the LHS side to complete the WM layer in the process. Features of the paver, if you see, the paver finisher shall be self-propelled, having the following features: loading hopper with suitable distribution mechanism to distribute the mix on both the sides of the pavers uniformly. The screed shall have a tamping and a vibrating arrangement for initial compaction to the layer as it is spread without rutting or otherwise marring the surface profile. The paver shall be equipped with the necessary control mechanisms so as to ensure that the finished surface is free from the surface blemishes, if any. So this is the typical photograph showing the loading hopper of the wet mix macadam paver, where the paver receives the WM mix from the dumper, and the screw conveyors or the conveyors as shown in the photograph on both the sides will be run or will move to collect the feeded material inside the paver, and then the material is being spread across on both the sides, so the left hand side and the right hand side of the paver, using a screw conveyor. So this is a small video showing how the screw conveyors are used in order to spread the material on both the sides of the pavers uniformly. This is the left hand side of the paver, where you can see that the screw conveyors are being rotated in order to shift the material from the center, and this is the right hand side of the paver. Now the typically the shaft needs to be completely submerged in order to move the paver in the forward direction. Precautions during laying of wet mix macadam, if you see, immediately after the mixing, the aggregates shall be spread uniformly and evenly upon the prepared subgrade or subbase or base in the required quantities. In no case shall these be dumped in heaps directly on the areas where these are to be laid, nor shall their hauling over a partly completed stretch be permitted. No segregation of larger and fine particles should be allowed. The aggregates as spread should be of a uniform gradation with no pockets of fine materials. While constructing the wet mix macadam, arrangement shall be made for lateral confinement of the wet mix. The longitudinal joints needs to be treated in such a way that during construction it should not develop loose pockets, and the joints needs to be always in a staggered position. Like if the width of the paving is say 5 meters and the width of the carriageway is 9 meters, then the paving will be done with a staggered position of 4 meters and 5 meters. And when you run the paver along the longitudinal direction, the junction, the joints between the two layers in the longitudinal direction needs to be staggered in nature. The string lines needs to be checked regularly for accuracy, and any disturbances in the strings shall be rectified before further processing the work. The PEX has to be at 10 meters center to center. Otherwise, if the PEX are at a larger distance, then the sagging of the string wires will have an impact on the levels of the WM being paved. For thickness of single compacted layers does not exceed 100 millimeters. Smooth wheeled rollers of 80 to 100 kilonewtons weight may be used. For a compacted single layer up to 200 millimeters, the compaction shall be done with the help of a vibratory roller of a minimum static weight of 80 to 100 kilonewtons or of equivalent capacity rollers. In portions having a unidirectional crossfall super elevations, rolling shall commence from the lower edge and progresses gradually towards the upper edges. Thereafter, roller shall progress parallel to the center line of the road, uniformly overlapping each preceding tracks by at least 1/3 width until the entire surface has been rolled. In portions in camber, rolling should begin at the edge with the roller running forward and backward until the edges have been firmly compacted. The roller shall then progress gradually towards the center parallel to the center line of the road. This is the photograph showing how the roller is being used in order to compact the WMM surface. The marks or the impressions of the rollers needs to be removed completely in order to ensure that physically or visually that the rolling is complete. Precautions during compaction of wet mixed macadam. In no case should the use of unmixed material be permitted to make up the depressions. Dry rolling should not be permitted because dry rolling will result in lesser field dry density. And when you check the compaction using sand replacement method, which is a ratio of field dry density to the maximum dry density, the percentage compaction will always be less. Therefore, dry rolling should not be permitted. The rolling has to be carried out with by keeping the moisture content at OMC plus 1-2%. Rolling shall be continued till the density achieved is at least 98% of the maximum dry density for the materials as determined in the laboratories. Precautions, further precautions to be taken during compaction of wet mix macadam is, after final compaction of the wet mix macadam courses, the road shall be allowed to dry for at least 24 hours. Preferably, no vehicular traffic of any kind should be allowed on the finished wet mix macadam surface till it has dried and the wearing course is laid. The speed of the roller shall be not more than 5 kilometers per hour at any point of time, because if the speed of the roller is more, the impact of compaction will be less, so thereby you will be resulting in less compaction even if the number of passes are more. So it is important to maintain the speed below 5 kilometers per hour in order to achieve the effective compaction by using a vibratory rollers. Rolling should not be done when the subgrade is soft or yielding, or when it causes a wave-like motion in the subbase or the base courses or the subgrades. That means if you have a bumping, then it needs to be rectified before starting the rolling. Some of the precautions, other precautions are, if irregularities develop during the rolling which exceeds 12 millimeters, when tested with a 3-meter straight edge, the surface should be loosened and pre-mixed material added or removed as required before rolling again. As so as to achieve a uniform surface conforming to the desired grades and crossfalls. Any displacement occurring as a result of reversing of the direction of a roller or from any other causes shall be corrected at once as specified or removed and made good without any further delays. So the some of the methods which one can adopt in order to protect the freshly laid wet mix macadam from rain is by covering the entire stretch using a tarpaulin sheet as shown in the photo. So this is the typical example of the loose materials or the bumping which is being observed in the wet mix macadam, and one has to correct the wet bumping of wet mix macadam before proceeding for the next layers. The correction can be done by either loosening the area and allowing it to dry, because bumping is nothing but the entrapped air. So you have to allow the material to dry so that the entrapped air is being evaporated, and then it can be compacted and made ready for the next layers. Otherwise, the best method is you have to remove and replace the material. Such bumping is possible when you have the problems like accumulation of fines at one particular location. And the accumulation of fines is directly related to the feeding of the wet mix macadam, which is ultimately being linked to the production, which we have already discussed during the precautions to be taken in the production stage. So in the production stage, if you are not able to control the segregation of fines and cores, then that will be ultimately resulting in as an accumulation of fines at one particular location in the wet mix plant or in the wet mix site. And those accumulation of fines, if the moisture is more, will lead to bumping. So to summarize this module, we talked about the laying of wet mix macadam, the role of loading hopper in the paver, precautions taken during the laying of wet mix, precautions taken during the compaction of wet mix macadam mixes, production of a freshly laid wet mix macadam from the rain, and production of wet mix macadam from the pumping. Thank you.